is the world.
Así que, pull up, pull up, pull up.
Okay. Nice curve.
Okay, nice one. Yeah.
Kev, look at slopes. Ooh. Kev, it's your first level 9. How do you feel?
Takot na ako.
Yeah, mixed emotions, no?
Excited, super excited.
Yes. So what about Giting-Giting that makes you pumped up?
I guess it's the fact that it's a level 9 mountain and I think the terrain is quite different. So exciting. 90-degree wall. Kiss the wall and all these things. And I think the view is fantastic.
It's your first time coming here. Your first level 9, quote unquote. So what part of the trail are you most excited about?
The whole rocky section. Mm. Just the
most thing. The... So the gymnastic part.
Yes.
One of the most difficult climbs in the Philippines is a hike to Mount Giting-Giting in Sibuyan Island, Romblon. This is because of the steep, jagged ridge called Knife Edge, which one has to cross in order to reach the summit. Not to mention the ensuing rock formations with colorful names such as Kiss the Wall and the 90-degree wall or Hillary Pass. Giting-Giting in the Romblomanon dialect means jagged. It is one of the focal points of Sibuyan's declaration as a biodiversity haven and has been dubbed by some local and international natural scientists as the Galapagos of Asia. The island of Sibuyan has been compared numerous times with the biodiversity endemism rate of the Galapagos Islands in Ecuador. Mount Giting-Giting, as discovered as a mountaineering hotspot during the early 1980s, an exciting period for Philippine mountaineering when the novel sport has just begun unraveling new and exciting destinations. In May 1982, a combined team of the Philippine Mountaineering Society and UP Mountaineers did the first exploration of the mountain, reaching the then unnamed Mayos Peak but failing to reach the summit. A few weeks later, some of them returned to make the first ascent to the summit. They were Mon Ruiz, Kim Valino, Bubotan Torre, and Edwin Gatia. Even without the accomplishment of getting to the summit, however, a visit to Giting-Giting is rewarding enough. To begin with, Sibuyan Island is a jewel of the seas. This island has beaches, waterfalls, and one of the cleanest rivers in the Philippines. Mount Giting-Giting is a culmination of this sanctuary, possessing what has been called the most diverse forest of the world, being the habitat of up to 54 endemic plant varieties. Moreover, Mount Giting-Giting is home to fascinating endemic flora and fauna. This include 4 species of rodents and a kind of bat discovered only in the mid-1990s and found nowhere else in the world. On the trek, hikers can attest to this natural richness with the presence of beautiful flora.
Oh,
Made it to Sibuyan Island and pretty much can't tell where we're going, which is Mount Giting Giting. It's one of the toughest trails in the country. When you say toughest, well, the informal rating of 1 to 9, 1 being the easiest, 9 being the hardest, it's rated level 9, mainly because it's quite technical and precarious. Not really of the much of a distance, but it's more of the technical aspects. But so far, the rest of the gang are sleeping while we're going to the market, explore the area, probably go to the beach. And we're enjoying the quiet life now. It's so quiet. You can lie down in the road for like a few minutes and no cars will pass by. Only chickens, cows. So we had to rearrange everything, like the logistics, the itinerary. Things didn't go as planned, but it's okay. We were able to manage. And we're gonna be here for an extra day, because the weather is not favorable, so we had to move it a day later. And then so we're just gonna take this day off and tomorrow do some shopping for supplies, and we're just gonna do a short run going to the market instead of taking tricycle, just to get our legs moving. Are you excited? It's your first level 9 after years of being with us. It's so ironic that it's just now he's doing the first level 9, even though he's been everywhere. And Clarice too is excited, much deserved break. Here we are, off to a wonderful adventure.
Well, I'm on my way to Bamako, a place I always wanted to go. On my way to Bamako, to see what I can see. Got a good friend there, Habib Kwate, a great musician, by the way. Got a good friend there, Habib Kwate, gonna meet his family. Africa, but I'm pretty sure in some kind of way.
Day two or three or two, yeah. We're just gonna do a short run. Weather's getting better. Looks like it's gonna be a good day to climb tomorrow. You can see the peak here a bit, so it shows up once in a while. Just do a short run just to keep ourselves occupied today. So it's gonna be a slow day. Just eat, sleep, run again. Eat, sleep, run. This is the life. Look at that. Giting Giting.
It's gonna feel like coming home. Well, I'm on my way to Bamako. Gonna leave behind ice and snow. On my way to Bamako to see what I can see. Gonna turn my face up to the sun. Close my eyes and thank the one. Turn my eyes up to the sun.
So, this is our setup.
And I'm pretty sure, in some kind of way, it's gonna feel like coming home.
Sound proper, we forgot our medical certificate, so we're doing a last minute checkup for the climb, which is a requirement, and print out our major climb certificates, which are needed. For climbing in the med cert and certificate of you climbing a difficult mountain, a major mountain.
It's my first trip to West Africa, and I'm pretty sure in some kind of way it's gonna feel like coming home.
It's 3:30, woke up at 1, did our breakfast, clean packed. We decided to take a tricycle now to the trail before starting the hike. So it saves us time, and also we're behind schedule. So I hope it offsets what the time that we lost.
The climb proper usually takes 3 days, but in our case, we modified it to just 2. Day 1 is the hike up to Camp 3 Olango side. 3 streams will be crossed before reaching Camp 1, and 3 camps will be passed before reaching Mayo's Peak. Then to the Knife's Edge, then to the Peak of Deception, then the summit, down to Spanya Peak, Renvaldelis Peak, and then to Camp 3. Day 2, we would be heading down to Olango's Knife's Edge, Camp 2, Camp 1, Olango River, then the flat section heading to the trail end. The trails are in very good condition and is surrounded by woodlands, mossy forests, and rock formations. The ascent to Gitingiting is just half of the adventure. The descent, it is said, is equally challenging as its technical features make it hard for trekkers to go at a fast pace. Once we complete the course, we opted to go to Cresta de Gallo, a remote island 1 hour boat away from the main island, to reward ourselves with some relaxing view of the Sibuyan Sea.
Exactly 6 a.m. and it's happening. We're in the trails. I just passed Camp 2. For now, it's all relentless climb. Forested area. Some blood leeches on the way, but not that much. They're not even that aggressive. Crickets, hear birds, and that's it for now. Okay, the forest is still somewhat house sleeping. There's the alarm clock.
Sorry.
So, sun is up, finally. gonna take a short break here, then proceed. Good weather. Skies are clear, sunny, just the right temperature. A part going to Maya's Peak. It's steep from Camp 3, it's just an hour or less if you're really fast. So it's rock scrambling, not all the way, but many parts pretty exposed and amazing. The flora, it's just so amazing. And if you don't know, there's a big issue going on right now in the mountaineering community. It's about this place under threat of mining. And there's a campaign going against it, and we also support the campaign, because all of this, if you've been here, it's hard to describe. You know, pictures and videos doesn't justify the beauty of this place, but you'll understand once you're here. It hurts to know that if this place gets quarried, mined, it's irreversible. That way to summit. Thing is, we plan is wait for them and go straight to Camp 3, the other trail, and camp there, time permits. Had our gallery break here in Maya's Peak, Udek. So here it is. Going there. Look at that ridge up there. About Mount Giting Giting, you know, the adventures, the first ascent, you know, Edwin's stories were amazing. I'm fortunate enough to meet some of the pioneers in this mountain, and they were so articulate in describing how the adventures went, you know, the former failures, lessons learned, you know, and coming back and finally doing the first ascent. It's amazing, you know, it's been like 40 years since that attempt was made, and I can imagine what it's like, you know, how precarious it was, how raw the trail was, so daunting, and like the technical sections, the ascents were relentless, gnarly. Thank you. lunch break at Mabel Springs. Curvin. Swapang sa water, sa food. Ay nako, haya. Stretch to the summit. Damn. Approaching the summit. Woo. So after that crux, 90 degree wall, you just a few meters away from the summit. Yeah. Lot of acrobats and gymnastic moves earlier. I guess that's the challenge of this mountain. It's not the distance, a bit of gain, but it's more of the technical aspect. But congratulations, guys. Cheers. Good job. Yep, this is the view from Gitting Summit. There's a peak of deception over there. And that island over there is Cresta de Gallo. Yan, si Kuya Jun. Susi namin. Galing, magaling na guide.
Obi loto lui, hagi bunde toke da.
Seen it, curves. Yeah, effective.
Yep.
So, remnants of the air crash back in the 80s. More of these. So many of these. Probably the biggest we've seen. Yep, really big. How many times did you guys trip, fall, twist your ankle, or cry? He cried probably like 2,000 times. He semi-cried. He's catching up. This one's a different species. After camp one, trail becomes easier. You can do fast hike and even run if you want. All the way. Woo! Trail exit! Whee! Woo! Yes. After hours of stealing our water and food, Kirvin makes it. Made it to Lang River. Finally getting our water. Look how clear it is. Amazing. Almost done. Some game, some mental game. Especially if it's your first time, it's gonna retest your patience. So it did to Kirvin. So we're just a few, I don't know how many meters, but we're just a few minutes away from the trail end. And I can say, Giting never fails to amaze. So Giting Iting, well now it's dense because it's closed for 3 years. So it took people longer to complete the whole trail, the whole course. But in a few months time, trails will be established again and it's going to be easier to hike. Yeah, it's still challenging. Now people are rating it as 9 of 9. There's a reason for that. But do try. Cheers. Okay, after
a
few hours, here's where we're gonna wait for Russ and Blee. So congrats, dude.
Yes.
Cheers. Yep. Quite a run. Celebratory drink. Yep. Okay, tricycle having a hard time. We had to go down some adventure. Russ met a new friend here in the hotel. Yeah. So I'm in the room with Kirvin. Finally made here in the hotel. After a long day, we finished at 2 and we're the lead back. And then Russ and Lee find it quite challenging, but ended it much later at around 7:30. So we had dinner at the very humble, modest place in Olango, and then from there we hired a tricycle, coming here to our hotel, and that's it. Tomorrow we're gonna be waking up really early, to catch the boat ride to Cresta de Gallo. And then from there we just stay for a few hours and go home, back to Manila. Congrats, you made it. Tough climb. Tough climb it is. Here we go.
We cross Zimbabwe's border, flew over the dry of my homeland, coming into Joburg. The suntan swimming pools and so into shirts, airports and railway stations, stranded with a rucksack and guitar. The languages and the places change.
Look at the color, turquoise, maybe white sand.
And there's small
Giting Iting,
sandbar. I may be walking in the streets of a city called Amsterdam, but the dust on my boots and the rhythm of my feet and my heart say Africa. Say Africa, say Africa, say Africa, say Africa, say Africa, say Africa, say Africa,
say Africa.
Sticks and stones and the UN law and passport controls for countries that don't exist. It's a big world, they have their own problems everywhere, and there's gold in that clenched fist. People
people ask me where I'm from. I say Mamelodi Township, in a city called Tswane, meaning we are the same. I have a friend who's a great musician and is from Ebayi, near King Williamstown. You know where Steve Biko was born. You might have heard or seen a film about Africa. You know it's the big continent with the great gift of Ubuntu. I may be walking in the streets of the city called London, but the dust of my boots and the rhythm of my feet and my heartbeat say Africa. I may be walking in the streets of the city called Amsterdam, but the dust on my boots and the rhythm of my feet and my heartbeat say Africa. Say Africa.